Boxers are warriors. We stand in the middle of a 20-foot ring going toe-to-toe with another warrior for 36 minutes. And the winner in that fight is the one who's able to take more courage and determination into that ring. But how does this relate to you? Well, it is the same for everyone in here. The parents, the mother, the father who's building and maintaining that strong family core. Or even that kid. I'm referring to some little kid who was on one side of the railroad tracks who wants to get to the other side. Just imagine. Imagine the obstacles and hurdles that you can overcome in your life if you took the same qualities of that confident boxing champion and applied them to every aspect of your daily life.
هذا هو شوغر راي ليوناخ، وهذه هي أفكاره، وهذه هي قناعاته. الملاكم بالنسبة ليه مقاتل، والمعركة اللي تصير على الرينج هي نموذج مصغر للعقبات والصعوبات اللي تصير للناس في الحياة اليومية. وقدامها الصعوبات، برشا تحدي وأمل، برشا قوة وإصرار، عزيمة كبيرة أيضاً خلاه من مسيرته تدخل لتاريخ رياضة الملاكمة كأحد أبرز وأنجح الملاكمين. وفي الأسابيع القادمة وعلى مدى مجموعة من الحلقات باش نزيدوا نتعرفوا أكثر على الملاكم اللي تحصل على 5 ألقاب عالمية في 5 أوزان مختلفة. الملاكم اللي تم اختياره دون منازع كأفضل ملاكم في ثمانينات القرن العشرين. وفي كاو أيضا باش نتفرجوا في أقوى اللقاءات اللي قدمها، ومع شوغر راي باش تتأكدوا أنه مش فقط ملاكم الوزن الثقيل هما اللي يصنعوا الفرجة في البوكس، وتأكدوا أنه الحلقات القادمة من كاو باش تغير نظرتكم لعالم الملاكمة. ولد شوغر راي ليوناخ سنة 1956 في مدينة ويليمكتون في ولاية نورث كارولينا في الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية. وبين أخواته السبعة كان هو الأكثر خجل وعقولية، صوته ما يتسمعش لا في الدار ولا في الشارع، الشيء اللي خليه عرضة للسخرية وللاستغلال من طرف أصحابه اللي أكبر منه. وباش يهرب من المشاكل بدأ شوغر راي يترنى ملاكمة وهو عمره 13 سنة، وهذا بتشجيع من خوه الكبير روجي. في عالم الهواية ما كانتش موافقة، وبعد مجموعة من الهزائم أصبح شوغر راي الملاكم اللي ما ينجم يربحه حتى حد. وفي بداية سنة 76 تمت دعوته للالتحاق بالفريق الأمريكي للملاكمة اللي باش يشارك في أولمبياد مونغيال، وفي النهائي انتصر على الملاكم الكوبي أندريس ألداما، وكان اللقب الأول في مسيرة شوغر راي ليوناخ. بعد فوزه بالذهبية الأولمبية فاجأ ليوناخ الجميع بقراره اعتزال الملاكمة وتفرغه للدراسة الجامعية، وهذا بعد 145 مباراة في مجال الهواية ربح منهم 140 ماتش منهم 75 بالكو. قراره بالاعتزال فاجئ كل اللي تابعوا بداية مسيرته، وإذا مدربيه وزملائه ما نجموش يقنعوه بالعودة للملاكمة، فإنه المشاكل المادية اللي لقاها بعد ابتعاده على الرينج أجبروه على اتخاذ قرار ثاني، احتراف الملاكمة. ونهار 5 فيفري 77 ربح ليونار لويس فيغا في أول مباراة احترافية له. وفي مدة عامين انتصر شوغر راي ليونار على 25 منافس منهم 16 بالكو. النجاحات اللي حققها شوغر راي بين عام 1977 وبداية 1979 رشحوه باش يتنافس على اللقب العالمي في وزن الوسط لبوا ويلتر. الموعد كان 30 نوفمبر 1979 في مدينة لاس فيغاس وأمام آلاف من المتفرجين. يلقى ليونار روحه أمام ويلفريد بينيتيز، ملاكم قوي في رصيده 37 انتصار وهزيمة واحدة. زعم شكون باش يكون الرابح، الخبرة متاع بينيتيز ولا الطموح متاع ليونار؟ التفاصيل نشوفوها في كاو.
So the first round of this eagerly awaited fight, Wilfred Benitez, the champion in the blue shorts on the right, against the golden boy of American boxing, Sugar Ray Leonard in the white shorts. This fight is the most expensive outside the heavyweight division. 2.2 million it's cost tonight. Both men probing for position there. Not many punches exchanged. There's the left jab from Sugar Ray Leonard. Benitez is a master boxer. He likes to counter punch. He's got a sharp jab. Leonard is considered to be the harder puncher of the two, though Benitez at 23 KOs out of 36 fights is a good puncher as well. And there's the Leonard jab, smacks into Benitez's face. Leonard throws a right hand which Benitez ducks underneath. Both men feeling each other out, although Leonard's prepared to go in there with a good right hand. Benitez is forced to respond with two body punches. Both are very good technical boxers. Leonard is a faster puncher. He scored 16 knockouts in 25 fights. Whipping punches from Sugar Ray Leonard as Benitez comes in. And there's the end of the first round. Both men stare each other down. And here we go in the second round again. Leonard again moving forward, probing with the left jab. Benitez is very watchful at the moment. They're both feeling each other out, seeing what each other has to offer. good exchange of left hands there. Leonard is relaxed. Benitez looks a little bit tight at the moment. He goes for the body with the right hand. Both those jabs dropped short from Sugar Ray Leonard. Leonard is the older of the two boxers. Benitez started boxing, turned professional at the age of 15. He holds the record as the youngest man to win a world championship at the age of 17 and a half. Leonard is 23 years old. Benitez is 21 years old tonight. There's a good exchange from Leonard. Ooh, and Benitez slips there. I don't know if it was the effect of the left jab. It could have been. His legs went from under him. A nice left jab from Sugar Ray Leonard. Leonard has dominated the first two rounds. And again, the stare up at the end of the second round. Start of the third round. Benitez in the blue shorts, Leonard in the white. It's been a quiet beginning to this 15-round fight. Both men showing each other a great deal of respect. So far, Leonard has shown the sharper punching, but again, they're keeping within range. It's Leonard's jab that's dominated the fight. It seems that bit quicker. Ooh, a good exchange from Leonard there. As Benitez lunged in, Leonard caught him as he came in. And two left hands from Leonard. Oh, and a left hand there from Leonard. And Benitez goes down. He's got to take the mandatory eight count. Leonard smiles in the corner. He knows he's got an advantage over Benitez now. He's knocked his man down. Benitez smiles as well, but that often means that a fighter's hurt. And Leonard smacks in the left jab, misses with the right hand. Is he going to go for the knockout now? At the end of the third round, Benitez smiles at Leonard to try and assure him that he's not hurt, but he certainly was hurt by that punch. Presses advantage on champion Wilfred Benitez. Both men are undefeated coming into this fight. Leonard's won 25 in a row with 16 knockouts. Benitez has had 36 fights with just one draw and 23 knockouts. But the Puerto Rican's record is longer. He's been 6 years as a pro. Leonard's only had 3 years in the pro game. Leonard scores with a sharp jab. He hasn't really gone after Benitez. Despite knocking him down in the third round, he hasn't really pressed his advantage. He's still jabbing carefully. Benitez is still playing a cat and mouse game with him. It's a chess match, a boxing match of great intelligence, great skill. Both men are very skillful. Carlos Padilla warns Sugar Ray Leonard there. Leonard misses with two wild punches, but that right hand gets through. You can see how Benitez bobs and weaves to avoid punches. He slips punches. He's a craftsman of the ring, but at the moment he's not throwing enough punches, and Sugar Ray Leonard is landing the better jabs, throwing the more ambitious hooks. Leonard misses with a left hook at the end of the fourth round. To fifth round. Sugar Ray Leonard with a definite advantage over Wilfred Benitez. He's outboxed him, landed the cleaner punches, scored a knockdown in the third round. Can Benitez come back into the fight? Benitez's problem is he's a counter-puncher. He likes his opponent to come in towards him. At the moment, Leonard is forcing Benitez to come forward. Benitez loves to lay back on the ropes, as he did in his last fight against Harold Weston. Lay back on the ropes and counter-punch. But Leonard's too clever for him. He's forcing Benitez to follow him around the ring. Left jab of Leonard's is wrapping into Benitez's face as he comes in. Both men stand 5 foot 10 inches taller, though Leonard looks the bigger man. Wilfred Benitez is a two-time world champion. He won the world title at junior welterweight against Antonio Cervantes in 1976. He never lost that title in the ring and moved up to welterweight to beat the famous Carlos Palomino in 15 rounds. As you can see, Leonard's forcing Benitez to come in and counter-punching him. The jab is rapping home against Benitez's face. Leonard relaxed, moving nicely. Benitez tighter, trying to slip punches, trying to force Leonard to follow him into the ropes. And a good exchange there. Leonard misses the right hand, and the bell goes at the end of the fifth round. They smile at each other as they return to their corners. And the bell starts the sixth round. The crowd are enthralled with this chess match of a fight. Sugar Ray Leonard in the white shorts, dominating with the left jab, throwing the more ambitious combinations against champion Wilfred Benitez. Benitez there, trying to get his jab going. Leonard is watchful, confident. Benitez working hard with his left jab in this round, trying to take the play away from Leonard. Leonard has never fought a 15-round fight before. He's pacing himself carefully, making sure that he's got plenty in his tank for the later rounds. Oh, and a clash of heads there. There's a clash of heads. Referee Padilla separates them. And there you can see blood on Wilfred Benitez's face. He's got a bad cut on his forehead there. Referee Padilla's looking at it. It's an unintentional clash of heads. The blood's running down from Benitez's forehead. You notice the corner aren't allowed to touch the cut. Padilla has wave them both together again, and this will have an influence on Wilfred Benitez. The blood is running down into his eye, into his mouth, and there he's attacking Leonard for the first time really in the fight. The bell ends the round. Benitez can get back to his corner for repairs here. Now Leonard's got the advantage. The blood still seeping from that cut is bound to affect Benitez. Leonard spearing at the blood with his left jab. And there, Benitez is inviting Leonard to follow him in. He desperately wants Leonard to come piling in so that he can counterpunch him, but Leonard, despite his 23 years, is far too clever for that. He's moving casually around the ring. The blood's running down Benitez's face. There you can see in close-up, going into his mouth. It's causing him a real problem. Every time Leonard spears his face with a jab, the blood gets worse. Again, a sharp burst of hooks from Leonard. He's showing far more variety tonight than Wilfred Benitez. Benitez relying mainly on the left jab and slipping and sliding under Leonard's punches. Benitez, normally a good body puncher, doesn't seem to be going for Leonard's body tonight at all. He's showing Leonard a lot of respect and a good left hook from Sugar Ray Leonard. There you can see the concentration on Sugar Ray Leonard's face. Benitez, the blood coursing down his nose into his mouth, moving in on Leonard all the time, but not really landing any significant punches. His punches aren't having much effect on Sugar Ray Leonard. Sharp left hooks, Sugar Ray Leonard. Fascinating exhibition of boxing from both men. Benitez rubs the blood away from his face. It's obviously bothering him. Leonard is content to be patient, pace himself. He's on top in the fight. Seems to have the measure of Wilfred Benitez. The end of the seventh round. Benitez complains about his eye as he goes back to his corner. And the eighth round here. Leonard in a comfortable lead against Wilfred Benitez, the WBC champion. Benitez's cornermen have seemed to have stopped the blood. Both men are patiently searching for openings here. There's not much footwork. They keep within punching distance. Not much inside work. Very few clinches. It's a real fight of technical ability. There again, three left jabs by Leonard land in Benitez's face. And the fourth. Benitez has no answer to that left jab. A good jabber himself. He just cannot get past Leonard's left jab. His own seems quite ineffective tonight. Benitez is showing a bit of frustration there. He tried a right hand and a left hook. Both missed. He can't really get to grips with the master boxer, Leonard, in front of him. The blood's seeping down from Benitez's forehead. He tries a wild right hand. Again it misses. That one catches Leonard, clips him on top of the head. Good right uppercut there from Sugar Ray Leonard. Just catches Benitez on the chin. Both their heads clashed again then. The blood comes out of Benitez's forehead. A good left hook to end the round by Sugar Ray Leonard. And a pat from Wilfred Benitez, a pat of respect as they go back to their corners. His respect was shown at the end of the round. He bows to Leonard as he comes out for the ninth round. Leonard's jab is dominating this fight. As you can see, Benitez trying to jab back. He's trying to get Leonard to move in towards him. He wants Leonard to make a few mistakes, but Leonard's far too cagey for that. A good left hook and right uppercut by Leonard. He's moving forward for the first time there, and that's what Benitez wants him to do. And some good work by Wilfred Benitez there. He jabs Leonard effectively and lands a right hand as they're in close, and a good left hook. And that stung Sugar Ray Leonard. There he goes for the body with the right uppercut. Right hand by Leonard. Benitez falls into the ropes. The crowd go mad there. Benitez shakes his head, saying that he wasn't hurt, but he was certainly hurt by that right hand. Three more good punches by Leonard, and again, the smile at the end of the round from Wilfred Benitez. And there's Leonard smiling at Benitez as they come out for the 10th round. Both men eager to get to work. Benitez has really got to start moving in. He does with a left hook. That's the first time that Leonard's looked slightly hurt in this whole fight. Benitez has really got to move in and start pressing Leonard. He's getting outboxed comprehensively at the moment, and Leonard can keep this up all night. Both men putting on a tremendous exhibition of technical boxing here. After the initial stare out at the beginning of this fight, they're showing tremendous respect for each other's ability. Benitez going for the body there. It's one of his favourite ploys, body punching. He's not used it so far in this fight. Two left hooks dug into the body of Sugar Ray Leonard there. Again, Leonard smiles at Benitez. He knows what Benitez is trying to do. Seems to be outthinking him. One step ahead, all the time. The blood's starting to seep from Wilfred Benitez's forehead again. Again, he launches two left hooks to the body. And a right hand from Benitez. Leonard ducks under the follow-over and pretends to windmill with his right hand to land the bolo punch. Bit of showboating for the crowd there, and they love it. Better round for Wilfred Benitez. He's moving in, punching to the body. Sharp right hand from Sugar Ray Leonard. He seems to be able to catch Benitez as he comes in, that right hand over the top of the left jab, and a left hook to the body from Sugar Ray Leonard. And a beautiful left uppercut. Benitez smiles. Again, it's the smile of a hurt fighter. Round 11 then. Oh, a tremendous right from Leonard. And Benitez is hurt, he's smiling, he's waving Leonard to come in. Leonard refuses to do so recklessly. One of the few clinches of the fight there. Padilla has to break them apart. Leonard works inside. Benitez has definitely stepped up the pace a little bit. He's throwing far more punches. He's trying to land right hands over the top. But Leonard can match him for anything he throws. Leonard likes to respond with hooks of his own as soon as Benitez starts throwing punches. That left hook hurt Benitez. You saw his legs tremble a little bit. He's in trouble here. He loses his gum shield. It's gone out of the ring. Benitez is in trouble on the ropes. Leonard smashes him with the left hook. Here you can see Benitez for the first time fighting off the ropes. It's the position he's most comfortable at, surprisingly enough. Although Leonard is so quick, Benitez is asking for trouble by laying on the ropes. As you can see, Leonard's working him over. Sweeping right hook by Leonard misses. Benitez backed off. He's ducking under those right hands. And he was definitely hurt. His gum shield went out of the ring. Here we have the 12th round. This is the furthest that Sugar Ray Leonard has ever gone. He's only boxed 10 rounds before. And he's paced himself well. He's dominating the fight against champion Wilfred Benitez. Been a quiet round so far. Leonard is content to let Benitez come into him and counterpunch as he comes in. Benitez using plenty of head movement, ready to slip that jab, but still not really throwing enough punches. He's allowing Leonard to dominate him with the left jab and sharp flurries of hooks. Oh, a sharp left jab from Leonard snaps Benitez's head back. And that's been Benitez's problem all night. He can't avoid that left jab. Leonard smacked it into his face time and again. Good right from Benitez, but he doesn't seem to be able to hurt Leonard at all tonight. Leonard has certainly hurt Wilfred Benitez so far. He's knocked him down, he's knocked his gum shield out, and that's the end of the 12th round. 13th round begins. Can Benitez pick up the pace? Can he really press Sugar Ray Leonard? He's got to get some action in there from somewhere. He's behind on points. He's got to force the issue. He doesn't want to go into Leonard, but I'm afraid he's going to have to do that to get back into this fight. Good left hook from Leonard. Leonard, of course, is the Olympic champion from Montreal in 1976, and he's had a wonderful pro career so far, and he lands with a right hand there. Benitez backs into the rope, but you can see how Leonard just moves away. He's not going to be suckered into going into the ropes and getting caught by Benitez's favourite counterpunches. Benitez again indicates to Leonard that he wants him to come in. Leonard, keeping his distance, tries a wicked right hand that misses. Benitez stays on the ropes. And Leonard goes in with him, switches feet there for a wide left hook, but misses it completely. Benitez watchful, but still not throwing enough punches to get back into this fight. Leonard's dominating. He knows he's ahead on points. He knows he's got plenty of energy left for the last couple of rounds. He knows that all he's got to do is keep this up to become the new champion. He's well in control. Combination from Leonard. Both men are super fit here. Benitez is known not to enjoy his training too much, but he's got himself into really good condition for this fight. A sharp left hook by Benitez clips Leonard, and Leonard is stung into action. He moves in again, and he counters with his own left hook. There's the end of the round. Leonard again nods at Wilfred Benitez as he goes back to his corner. You're saying you're posing with this guy. You've got to hit him with a left hook to the body. But Leonard's got the fight well under control. Here we are at the beginning of round 14. Two rounds to go in this WBC welterweight championship. Sugar Ray Leonard in the white shorts, Benitez in the blue. Leonard dominating the fight with his left jab. He's knocked Benitez down, he's cut him on the forehead. What can Benitez do to get back into the fight now? He's got to start really pressurizing Leonard. And every time he does that, he walks into Leonard's sharp countering hooks. Blood begins to seep from Benitez's cut. Leonard's far more able to produce sharp punches. There you can see he's faster than Benitez. His hooks are quicker. He's more willing to chance his arm with the right hand as he throws his right hand there, follows with a flurry, and gets away as Benitez tries to counterpunch. Benitez walks into two punches there. He's really got to press the issue, but Leonard is watching him, counterpunching him, outboxing him. At the end of the 14th round, we've got one round to go. The touch gloves. It's been a fine, crafted, technical fight. And Benitez really needs to go for Leonard in this last round if he wants a chance of retaining his title. And indeed, they're going to exchange punches. Leonard got the better of that one. Benitez is prepared to chance his arm now. He's only got these 3 minutes to do it in. Leonard, again, he's quicker to the punch. He whips in those hooks. Leonard throwing hooks and uppercuts. Benitez concentrating on the body. Leonard scoring well on the inside. And a good exchange of left hooks there. Benitez is really going for it now. He's trying hard, but Leonard is matching him punch for punch. Benitez landed a good left hook. The blood's coming from his forehead. Leonard's still out-punching him. He throws a flurry there at Benitez. A left hook lands. Benitez is being out-punched even in this last round. A masterful display of boxing from Sugar Ray Leonard here. Both men are beginning to tire a bit after their efforts. But they're putting in a rousing last round for the crowd here. Caesars Palace in Las Vegas. Benitez lands two solid hooks on Leonard. And a left hook from Leonard, and Benitez is down in the last round. He's up, he's shaking his head, going to the neutral corner. There you can see the blood coming from his forehead. He's looking a bit dazed here. He sucks in the breath as Padilla asks him if he's all right to continue. Benitez, as all true fighters, says he is, but Lenny's going in for the kill here. And Padilla stops the fight. It's right at the end of the 15th round, at the end of the fight. Sugar Ray Leonard is the new WBC World Welterweight Champion. And there's Benitez. He's not protesting about the stoppage. Benitez and Leonard embracing after a fascinating fight. Sugar Ray Leonard wins the World Welterweight Championship.
في مباراة مثيرة للغاية، تمكن ليونارد من افتكاك اللقب العالمي 6 ثواني فقط قبل نهاية الروندة 15 من الماتش. والماتش هذا تم اختياره من مجلة رينج ومن جمعية الملاكمين الأمريكيين كأفضل مباراة بوكس لسنة 1979. في فيديو الأسبوع باش تتعرفوا على معجزة الكيك بوكسينج، نسيم الملقب بالتنين الصغير واللي عمره 12 سنة، نسيم The Young Dragon كاو.
Oh!
الجمعة جاية في كاو، شوغر راي يسافر لكندا للدفاع عن اللقب.